No, you should. Don't let it in. Don't let it in. Not in.
You know, as I said, I was having a different topic, walking in the spirit and everything, but this goes back to even my own life when I was diagnosed with tuberculosis back in 1999, 2000, and I was in the chest hospital for 3 months in the intensive care unit.
Hallelujah.
So you can't just imagine every move. I could, at one point, I could not walk, I could not eat, I could not keep anything down. I was like a vegetable. The nurses said to me when I came into that hospital, they thought I was an old woman and I was a young girl. And if when one thing happened, then the medication that I was given to take care of my lungs, it started affecting my liver.
Oh God.
Then they had to take me off of that medication and pause. So then the whole condition relapsed. So instead of me getting better, I started getting worse. And then, you know, when one part of your body is affected, then the other part of your body is also affected.
Yes.
Then it started affecting my heart. So they say, no, you cannot move from the bed. You do everything in this bed. You eat, you drink, you sleep, you do everything right here. But, you know, I am here today.
Hallelujah.
Because of the goodness of God. And, you know, to top it all off, when I could move and I could help myself. So the nurse was told to take me to the bathroom and have me showered because I couldn't even do that for myself. And I was only 23 years old, mighty God. But you know what happened? That nurse left me. She took me and put me in an old rusty chair in the bathroom and she left me and she got to go to her business. And the only thing that came to mind was, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. And so, Sister Melinda, tonight I am saying to you, as the scripture came to mind, that you can do all things through Christ who strengthens you. This is why I started off, you know, I must have a Savior with me. This is when we are going to need a Savior.
Yes.
Oh God, you're going to need somebody to help you on this journey. You're going to need His loving arms to keep you.
Yes.
And oh God, your sister, I don't know what her name is, Brenda. Oh God, we give you Jesus because through this I know that you can overcome to the blood of Jesus Christ. I know that our God is able.
Yes.
He has done it for me and many others. If we should testify again tonight, I am sure church would not go over.
Yes.
And that is just a little part of my testimony. Do you understand? So, I mean, I cannot say I know what it is to lose a mom because I've never lost one. I don't know what it is to lose a sister, but I lost a brother. And so, when I got so emotional yesterday at the funeral, when my brother died, it was 1993, and her sister was born 1993. So it was like a fresh wound opening up, you know. But to God be the glory for the great things that He's doing. He's starting a work in your life, my sister, and He'll see you through. He's not a God to start a work and leave it halfway. He's the God is gonna see you through. Never leave you alone. He promised that He will comfort us. He promised He's gonna see us to the end of our Christian journey. So be encouraged. Oh God is a mighty portion. And He will take care of us. Because He promised in His word. Oh God, He will not leave us comfortless. Oh God is a God who cares. For this reason He came. That is why He said, I am. That's my name. And I believe we should start using that name more often. I am. I am your comfort. I am your healer. I am your provider. I am your sustainer. I am your helper. Oh God. Oh Jesus. Church.
Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Jesus.
Oh God. He said, I am your mountain mover.
Yes.
I am the bridge of your troubled water.
God.
Oh God. I can fix everything that is wrong.
Yes.
Because He's the creator of everything.
Yes.
He created each and every one of us.
Jesus.
We belong to God.
Yes.
We have a So whatever the condition is tonight,
yes.
Brother Chuck, I am is here.
Yes.
He said, I am here to take care of every need.
Yes.
Oh God, every need, He said, He supplies.
Yes.
The song we just sung, He said, you are important to me.
Jesus.
We are all important to God tonight.
Yes.
We are important.
Hallelujah. Yes.
Glory to God, glory to God. We cannot all understand the mystery that surrounds God.
Amen.
But He's well able.
Yes.
Oh God, His ways are past finding out.
Yes.
Hallelujah. His wisdom is unsearchable. Hallelujah, Jesus. Glory to God in the highest. Mighty God, thank you, Jesus. Oh God, He's our master. Oh God.
Yes.
When the waves of lies are overhead, they're still under His feet.
Yes.
Hallelujah. So we can stand bold in Him tonight. Hallelujah. We can exercise our faith.
Yes.
Oh God, knowing that our God is a mighty fortress.
Mm.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
My God, I don't even have a topic. I'm just
talking about
it. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Oh, glory to God. But if I should choose a topic, I should say I am.
Yes.
Because the I am is in the house.
Yes.
Hallelujah. that we need to have more respect, and that's true.
Yes.
Because if we don't respect ourselves, then nobody will respect us. Yes. Mighty God, hallelujah, Jesus. So as children of God, we know that we are kings and priests. Oh, we are royalty in the name of Jesus. Oh, glory to God, because we are connected to the I Am. And He is our Lord and our Savior. He's our King and He's our Master. Hallelujah, Jesus. That's the God that we serve. That's the God that we serve tonight. So whatever it is, hallelujah, whatever is the condition, we have the I Am in the house. Hallelujah, Jesus. Glory to God. Mighty God. So I was speaking when I said I can do all things through Christ from Philippians 4 and verse 13. That's where I was. Hallelujah. So if you want to turn with me to Philippians 4. Hallelujah. Let's go to verses 6. And then, hallelujah, I'll stop at verse, well, I'll probably just, hallelujah. Be careful for nothing, but in everything by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known unto God. And the peace of God, which passeth all understanding, shall keep your hearts and mind through Christ Jesus. Finally, brethren, whatsoever things are true, whatsoever things are honest, whatsoever things are just, whatsoever things are pure, whatsoever things are lovely, whatsoever things are of good report, if there be any virtue, if there be any praise, think on these things. And then I jump over to verse 13. That's where I started, where I said, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Hallelujah, Jesus. We have a wonderful God. He's an awesome God. Hallelujah. When I think of the goodness of Jesus and what He has done for me,
my soul
cries out, hallelujah, thank God for saving me. Thank you, Jesus. When I think of the goodness of Jesus and what He has done for me, normally talks about my testimony when we got married and my womb was a mess.
Amen.
And I could not produce.
Amen.
For my husband. And you know, I remember I was at home and I went to church. I normally like to go to fasting services, you know?
Yes.
And at the time, we, you know, because we're coming from the New Testament Church of God, it was the Reverend Arthur Grant who was preaching that crusade. And I left work. I was working at Sanders at the time, and I left work and I rushed home because I wanted to hear everything what that was happening. I wanted to be a part of everything, you know? And so when I went there, I realized that the preacher was touching me because he hit some bits. You know when the preacher preach and I'm going to talk about you, not true?
Yes.
You know when I'm connecting you and I say, yes, that piece there for me, other piece there, you know? Yes. And so he said, somebody's day off is going to be this Wednesday. And you need to be on fasting and don't be late.
Amen.
And I'm like, wow, that sounds like he was talking to me because sometimes I do have a problem with being on time because I'm always like fasting. You know, but you know, to cut a long story short, you know, when he said that, I thought about it and then I brushed it aside. But then I said, no, let me go on this fasting. And so you know what? I said, I'm going to have an appointment with God. And I made it a date with the Almighty God. And so what I did that Wednesday morning, I got up early and I ensured that Pastor was off to work and everything was all right. And I cleaned up the house nicely because I was going to have an encounter with the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. And if God is going to come into my house, I have to make sure that my house is clean. So I went ahead and I cleaned my house up nicely. And then I said, if I'm going to have a date with the King of Kings and the Lord of, then my body must also be clean. So I went to the bathroom and I got myself all together, you know, I put myself together. Then I said, if I'm going to meet the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, then I need to put myself together. So I chose the finest suit that I had.
Yeah.
I went into my closet, brothers and sisters, and I chose the best suit, Sister Samantha, that I owned.
Yes.
And I took off the best pair of shoes that I owned. Yeah. And I put them together and I said, he said, I should not be late. So I got ready and I sat down with the word of God and 5 weeks tonight. I sit down at my house and I said, my mind started talking to me, but you're mad. What are you doing?
Yes.
And then quickly brush it aside because you know what happened? I felt the presence of the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords enter into that room.
Yes.
And my God, my life has never been the same. Because I had an encounter. Hallelujah, with the King of the universe. Hallelujah, Jesus. Because there were days, my brothers and sisters, when I was just existing, but I was not living.
Yes.
Anybody been there?
Yes.
I was existing, but I was not alive.
Yes.
Nothing going for me.
Yes.
Me married, nothing going. Me at work, nothing going. Me see I'm a Christian, but still nothing going.
Yes.
And I know that I have to meet with God so that the situation could be changed.
Yes.
Brothers and sisters, when the presence of God came into my house. I was living in Paris at the time because that's where a matrimonial home is. And God visited me, I am telling you. I had a friend in Chicago, Pastor normally talked about the testimony. She said to me, Liesa, you know, if you had a visa, I'd give you a trip up here to Chicago. I said, really? But you know, I heard her, but you know, that not then nowhere near me right now because my life not going good, much more to think about visa for God. You understand? That was the last thing on my mind. You understand? Yes, because I had my personal mayhem. You understand? I went to the doctor every time we get me, every month. Me get the pay and me care about the doctor. The doctor, they love me, you see. Because every time me get this hurry, I see it here. He know me, I see, he see me, I come and start laugh because I hear me when I work for. My God in heaven. And I had the healer. And I didn't know God has the healing. Because my pain was weak. My God Almighty. Nice place at Chicago, no one big old daddy, but then host me and Fred. And she and Fred, I get everything.
Yes.
And Jesus knows that me, he picked me out here in Jamaica.
Yes.
Aye! Jesus. you don't think it's gonna happen?
Yes!
Oh God! Why somebody don't want to trust God tonight?
Yes.
My God!
Yes!
Hallelujah, thank you, Jesus. Shall we lift our hands and love it?